Hello all. I'm audible. Are you able to hear me? Hello?
Yes, yes. Ah, yes, yes.
Okay.
Hello.
So my screen is also visible to you all.
Yes, Anurag, it is visible.
Okay. So we will start sharp 7:30. So still we have 8 minute time left. So we are waiting for other participants to join. So we will wait for another 1 minute and then we can start. Right now I have unmuted you all. So if you want to say something, then it's okay. Otherwise, we can start. Anybody want to say something, or we can start now. And
yes, Anurag sir, we can start. And Happy New Year to all.
Yeah, Happy New Year. In this session, we have 2 hours. So I just muted you all right now. And so if you have any questions, then you can put in chat window or after binding of the session. Before that, we are one section, that is question answer section. So we can cover all those question answer in this section. So now I'm putting you all in mute. Now I am starting. So you are aware that this session is for the Oracle Flex ASM and Flex Cluster. So we are covering this Oracle Flex ASM, Flex Cluster, and we will also see that a few demos on live servers. So before proceeding with this topic, means few participants are means even not aware about the rack and clusterware and all. So I'm just quickly covering those part, few things, and then we can start this Flex ASM and Flex cluster. So first, I wish you a Happy New Year, and hope you're all means you will get more success in this year, and you will achieve more and learn more. And now myself is Anurag Mishra. I have done many certification, and I have that almost. 2 decade experience in database technology. Currently, I am in working in a top MNC as a senior lead DBA, and I am frequently taking these webinars and other forum. I am speaking all those topics, database related topics. So, in this agenda, what is our agenda for the today? So today we are going to be quickly covering this clusterware and ASM and racks part, and we will see that flex cluster. Then we can see that the flex cluster functionality. Then we can see that the how we can migrate from standard to flex cluster, and then we can see that flex ASM and the flex ASM functionality, and how we can move the standard ASM to the flex ASM, and what is the changes in 18C and 19C regarding this flex ASM and flex cluster. And live demo we have, and we have the question and answer. So first we are starting with the cluster. What is the cluster? Actually, cluster is nothing, a group of independent but interconnected computers act as a single systems. Here in the picture you can see that there is a multiple, means different computers are there, but they are put it in the such a way that they forms one cluster. So a group of independent but interconnected computer that act as a single system. Usually deployed to increase the ability and performance to balance the dynamically changes workload. The reason behind this cluster is that we require to want the system to high abilities or and load balancing also. So that time this rack system comes in the picture. Clusterware things comes in the picture. Next is a cluster is a interconnected of multiple system forms as a one unit is called cluster. Then what is the clusterware? Clusterware is a software that provides various interface and services for the cluster. Typically this includes the capability that. So in the layman language, you can say that the clusterware is like cluster is a software which form which makes the system as a cluster. So allow that the cluster to be managed as a whole. So clusterware allows to manage a cluster completely, protect the integrity of the cluster, maintain the registry of resources across the cluster. Clusterware is responsible to maintaining the resources and within the cluster. And whatever changes modification is that is done by the clusterware, provided common view of resources. So in one place you can able to view that all those resources running on the different node. You have the 100 node system or rack system, then you want to see that which resources is running on which node, then you can on one places you can find that those things easily. So this is the main features of cluster. And then after that, Oracle clusterware. So if you remember that in 9i, we have that we don't have that Oracle clusterware. Before putting this Oracle clusterware, we required one third party clusterware. On top of that, we can put this Oracle clusterware. So that is called that time that the different vendor is there. I remember one is Veritas clusterware. So in 9i installation, we are doing that. We are first installing this, means putting this Veritas clusterware, and on the top of the Veritas clusterware, we are installing this Oracle clusterware. So 10G onwards, 10G onwards, we have that both option is there. Either you can use this third-party clusterware utilities, or you can directly install this Oracle clusterware 10G onwards. And 11G, we have that many new features are introduced in 11G. So after that, in 12C, this Oracle Flex and Flex Cluster comes in the picture. So clusterware software, so like that Oracle clusterware. What is Oracle clusterware? So Oracle clusterware is a software which developed by Oracle is called that Oracle Grid Infrastructure. And before that, in Tenji, we have that ASM, Oracle ASM is a separate Oracle home. And other grid and this one is another Oracle home. But in 11G onwards, this ASM is also in the same Oracle, means same grid home. So we don't have the two different home. We have that a single home concept here. So Oracle cluster is a part of Oracle Grid Infrastructure integrated with the Oracle Automatic Automatic Storage Management ASM, and is the and you know that means the ASM on the ASM we can create that ACFS file system. ACFS file system is like on ASM we can create ACFS. So is like a normal file system, but actually it resides on the ASM. And regarding this, you know that in Exadata we are using the DBFS file system. So it's similar to that. DBFS is a little bit different. That is database inside the database we are using that file system. But same like that is like one normal file system, and that it resides on the ASM. That is called ACFS file system. This is the foundation. Oracle cluster is foundation of Oracle Rack. Using this Oracle cluster where we are forming this cluster type of things. This is the Oracle cluster where. So in picture also you can see that it's very clear that this set of system making one cluster where, and these are the storage, means that is ASM disk you can say. And is using by this clusterware, and the user is connected to via network to this clusterware, and is clusterware is redirecting this load balancing that the different system based on the services service name is maintained on those system. Based on that is distributing the load on the different nodes. So we will see in the further. So what is the goal of the clusterware? The goal of clusterware is first is easy installation. So if you want to put the set of system in one unit, then that easy installation. Before that, we have that third party clusterwares that is very complicated and it's a different vendors. So sometimes we are facing the different issues, but actually is handling by the different vendors. So response time is very slow. So first thing is a very easy to install, easy management, and is tightly integrated with the this one rack system cluster, and ASM enhancement is there, and no additional software is required to put the clusterware. Till 9i we required that additional clusterware software, third party vendor software, but after 10G we do not require any additional clusterware software or something other than Oracle clusterware. So now in 11G release 2 onwards we have this clusterware put it at the grid plug and play. So what is meaning of the grid plug and play? Before that, whenever we require to add the node or require to remove the node, that is very complicated task. And we require to put the many things to make that things are successful. So in 11G release 2 onwards, is a great plug and play things was means introduced. Like if you want to add that node, then it's very easy. You can easily add that node without putting the cluster down or something, or removing the node also is very easy. So whenever you want to add the node to balance the system or loads on the system, you can add that node. Sometimes in many clients, in our clients also, we are seeing that they are maintaining the spare servers in the cluster. Suppose we have that 4-node cluster. So 3 we are using for the databases and 1 we are only putting into the cluster, that is grid infrastructure software is installed, but we are not using that system and we are not putting any load on that system. That is for the spare servers. So whenever required or something happened and we required to make it this server to live server, then we will only do this Oracle home cloning, and then we can run that root dot sh, and that server will means that things will ready to handle the databases and other services. So like same, so whenever we require to remove any nodes, so it's very easy. So that's why it's called the grid plug and play. So later on we can see that what is this grid plug and play, what is that GPNP profiles, how this OLR means how these things are working internally, and how this when the system, when the cluster is started, then how which process is picking which files, and how this whole startup process is working. So that is the different topics. So now this grid naming service GNS is essential or mandatory for the flex cluster. So if you want to use this flex cluster things, the grid naming services is required. So what is this grid naming services? I think everybody is aware that DNS, domain name services, everybody knows that in means you can say that on the IP addresses having some defined name, that is called DNS. So it's registered in the DNS. So if you typing that google.com, so actually this google.com inside that some IP addresses is there. So that IP addresses name is google.com, like yahoo.com. So those which provided those naming thing is called DNS. So we have aware that DNS things. So same like grid naming service, GNS is also same, where this but these things used by the Oracle cluster where. So in GNS, if you means configure that GNS as a domain in that during that installation, that time you do not require to means everybody is aware that for cluster installation we required minimum 3 scan IPs on each node. We required 3 IPs, one for the public IP, one of, for the VIPs, and one for the private IPs. But when you using this GNS as a domain, that time you are only required that public IPs. Even your private IPs and VIPs you can handle through this GNS. So GNS, whenever this new system is joined in the in the domain or in the cluster, then that time the GNS will provide that IP addresses using means required that DNS and DHCP is configured on that system, and that is automatically provide that name and that IP addresses to the admins that new system. So GNS is a integrated component of grid plug and play, GNS means itself required that static IP address registered in DNS, means you do not provide this dynamic IP addresses to GNS virtual IPs. So virtual IPs required the static IPs, and the cluster subdomain is defined as a delegate domain. Means like if you are saying that using that gns.oracle.com, then gns.oracle.com is a subdomain of that one. Means like when the new system is will join, that naming is like rack4.gns.oracle.com. So that those things are configured in DNS cluster subdomain. And a request is to resolve it, and this scan IPs is directly is not coming through the GNS, it's directly coming to the DNS. So this means four static things are required pre installed. Like one is GNS VIPs, and three rack IPs are required to register in this you can say that in a DNS. So the total number of four IPs required to register, static IP address is required to register to use this GNS services. Just a second. So let me unmute you all then. So till that point is okay, or I'm going fast, or I'm going slow, or is means difficult to understand. Can anybody give the comments? I just unmuted all.
Yeah, go. Good. Under.
Okay. So like this is, so in our case, if you see that when I fire this NS lookup rack scan, rack is my cluster name and rack hyphen scan is the scan IPs. So when I fire this command, it's going to this 192.168.0.200. That is my DNS. So it's going to that and fetching those three IPs here. So these are the three scan IPs. And now what is this scan name? So I already told you that what is the scan. So scan name is the single client access naming. So whenever that application or client is accessing that your system, so you have that 10 node rack system. So you have scan name. So you will provide this scan name to the customer that this is the scan name, or you put it those scan name in the application. So suppose if you are adding, removing, or based on your requirement in the cluster, it does not impact that connectivities or does not require any changes in the application side. So scan name is provide one. So how this scan name is working? Scan name is act as a load balancer. So whenever the request is coming from the application or client side, it will be see that which node is a less load. So it's transfer that things to that node. And node, in every node, there is a local listener is running. So this is listener will transfer these things to the local listener. So local listener will act and perform those actions, connect with the database and do the required action, and then hand over the things to this scan, and that things are returned. So this way, these things are working. So a scan is a type of load balancer, which balancing the load on the cluster. And is a minimum 3 scan IPs is required during this rack installation. And is a cluster will decide that the scan IP is run on which node. So you have the 10 node rack and having only 3 scan IPs. So any node, it will be running. So is decided by the cluster. So, but how you can see that means in a different method, we can see that during this performance and all, that sometime we have seen that the multiple requests are coming and 3 scan listeners are not enough to maintain this, those things. So that time we can increase this scan things and we can add more. So that time so it depends on the requirement, depends on the load. During this performance tuning things, we can see that all those things, that how we can increase this scan things and how we can identify that this scan thing is required to increase and which basis we require to increase this scan thing. So here also you can see that if I have this command and I've put it this DNS name and I have put it this scan IPs is find the way is going to that direction and find these 3 IPs. So you return the 3 IPs. Sorry. Now, what is the ASM? So ASM is nothing as a volume manager and is a Oracle product and is integrated with the cluster-based utilities and software. So on the top of that file system is maintained, create one ASM. That ASM software is at top of that file system and that is ASM is maintaining that things for the rack or without rack also we are using in the standalone system. Sorry. ASM install in the grid infrastructure home separate from the Oracle database home. So ASM things are installed in the grid infrastructure home, not on the Oracle database home. And it's reside in the top of the file system. And it's both cluster and non-cluster environment also. If you are not using this cluster also, you can easily install this ASM. Non-cluster databases, means standalone databases. So I'm not focusing on those part in details because this is a class for the different purpose, but many participants are requested that I go for the starting, then it will be better for them. So overview of Oracle Rack. So I'm not wasting more time on that. I'm just reading those things and just moving further on that part. The today for today agenda. overview. So we have already discussed these things. Oracle Rack. What is the Oracle Rack clusterware and those things. So I'm just skipping this slide. Benefit of using a rack with high abilities, surviving node and instance failure. So any node, any host will fail, then the load will be transferred to the another node. The high ability, scalability means adding more node or removing nodes does not impact that connection of application or client. So no impact on that. So scalabilities, pay as you grow. So if you have more load, then you can add more node and grid key. grid future is growth and syncage on demand, add or remove node. single button addition of server means we have that single script to add this means extend this grid to another node. Automatic workload management of for the services, that is the load balancer through scan. So now I am coming to the our original agenda. So original agenda is a flex ASM and flex cluster. So before going to that direction, first we try to understand that why these things are required. So in if you see that in the pre 12c means 11g 10g you can see that this is our actual standard cluster system where we have that application and we have some services. Through that services we are connecting to the RAG databases, and RAG databases also you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4 these are the nodes, and these are the standard nodes, and is connected to the shared storage so is connected to the shared storage. So this is the standard things, means application is also outside of the cluster, it's not part of the cluster, and that every node we have that means in the standard cluster we have every node we have that ASM instance is running if shared storage is used by ASM, and this way this application is connecting in a 12c pre RAG systems. So what is the restriction of 12c grid functionality? So software based clustering using a grid infrastructure, all cluster nodes contain database and ASM instances, means before that on each node we have that ASM instance running, and data if you are putting the database is also, the database is also running. Homogeneous configuration means one type of configuration, no changes on that. Shared everything model means every database or every node having the ASM and databases. Application user connect via node outside that the cluster, means application and other users are not part of the cluster, is connecting to the outside of the cluster. Reflect point to point model, you see, is connecting to the point to point model, it's not as a multi point model. And now in the same required a lot of resources, so in a pre 12c we required lot of resources. Why we are saying that? Suppose we have that 16 node rack system, so 16 node rack system. So heartbeat path is, means each node is checking each other. So if you multiply that those things, then it will becomes to 120. So 120 different heartbeat paths are means that network will be busy to checking the each other. And storage also, if you have 16 node, then storage also is checking that. We have two type of heartbeat, one is a network heartbeat and one is a storage heartbeat. So this storage heartbeat is 16 times checking, and each other checking network, that is 120. So if you put, suppose we have the 100 nodes, then this much 4950 times is checking that in every minute is checking that heartbeat is connection. So that will create the extra load on your network. So first one is requires a lot of resources, is correct. Through this example, each node is connected to the other node via interconnected for node to node heartbeat. Yes, each node is connected to each other, so it's a node to node heartbeat. Each node is connected to the storage directly. Each node is directly connected to storage. That's why you have 100 node, then 100 heartbeat for the storage also. So this is the calculation is put it here, and you can see that here is the more load on the system. So in the picture you can see that here that we have that this database system. So we have that each means every database we have that ASM instance running. If you see that ASM instance running on every node, and these are the disk group like data or record disk group, and this is the ASM storage pool. So every node having that ASM instance is running. So that ASM instance is also creating that extra load on the server. And we have already seen in the previous slide. So now and mapping over observation and mapping also, you can see that every server having that ASM instances running. And one more thing, that every client accessing that client means that the database is accessing that file system via local ASM instance only, not the remote ASM. It's the pre-12c, that is not means that time. This is only concept that each node having own ASM. Otherwise, if you put the databases on that server and ASM is not there or ASM is down, then all databases will not connect. That is the pre-12c. So in this scenario that ASM is a overhead still and cluster reconfiguration event are increased. So during this cluster reconfiguration or something, then you required that extra efforts to think that how you can maintain this ASM instance as well as the database instances. Now then why we required this flex ASM and flex cluster. So that is introduced in 12c release 1. So in release 1 we have that concept that flex ASM and flex cluster. So what is this flex ASM? First, so first the flex ASM is nothing like in the cluster means each node is not required to having that own ASM instance. So in this picture you can see that every hub node is not have the ASM instances. If you see that hub node 3, there is no ASM instances, but it still is working. And in node 4 and 1 and 2, we are having the ASM instances. By default, that we have that 3 ASM instances required in a flex ASM concept. So flex ASM is nothing like flex ASM is work use that ASM network. So through ASM network is connect that ASM instances. Like database we are connecting through the listener, and listener is creating inside that maintaining some services, that through that services we are connecting to the databases. Same like is a ASM network is introduced. So ASM listener is running on all those system. And that ASM listener is creating one ASM services inside, and that ASM services having the different load balancer like ASM 1, ASM 2, ASM 3. So when this client here ORCL 3 is try to connect that any instances is use the ASM listener running on this node 3, and is going to the ASM services. And ASM services, you will see that through the load balancer and all, it will be transferred that request to the any node which running in the ASM. So so this way that ASM is connected, and through ASM is connected to the data files and all. So this way is working. So it create the less load on the server because each ASM is not directly connecting to the storage. So storage heartbeat is also less. So, and now in top of that, you can see that flex ASM cluster means cluster flex cluster is also there. So flex cluster is like leaf nodes concept. Later slides, we can see that what is the leaf nodes. So here you can see that the leaf nodes is connected to the hub nodes. But in a leaf node, you do not see that any databases or ASM is running. It's an application tier. So what is this application tier and what is the benefit of that? We will see. So you just understand that is a Flex ASM, like means introduced in a 12C that uses this ASM listener or ASM network and maintain this way. And so in if you have that multiple node cluster, then it does not require to each node having the ASM minimum. Recommended value is 3, but minimum you can put the 2. At least 2 ASM is required to running in the system. By default is taking 3. So this way is working. And in to handle means maintaining this Flex cluster, you require GNS. But using this Flex ASM, you do not require the GNS. You can use this Flex ASM without GNS also. Now, what is this Flex cluster technologies? And so here, you can see that here we have that 4 node rack system is connected with the ASM or said storage. And each node, each hub node means this boxes where that which having the direct access to access this ASM shared storage, that is called the hub node. So hub node is providing services to the leaf node. So whenever leaf node is required to get some data, is go via hub node and then connect to the shared storage and get the data. So leaf node are basically maintaining that application thing like EBS, Sybil, other Dimantra and all those things are maintained on the leaf node. You can say that. But it is part of the cluster. Now, Flex cluster. So we understand that we have the 2 type of node in a Flex cluster. One is called hub node and one is called the leaf node. A hub node is you can say that the database ASM instances or VIPs are running, that is called the hub node. So in hub node, database ASM instances or VIPs are running, that is called hub node. So question is that if database is not running or ASM is not running, so can is called as a hub node? Yes, because we have that in the same cluster and we have that VIPs is running. So that is called the hub node. And what is the leaf node? Leaf node is like, leaf node is, purpose of leaf node is to provide that services to the application. So basically in the leaf node, that application are running on the leaf node. And is connected to the hub node. And loosely coupled means like a leaf node is sometimes connected to hub node and that hub node is not available, is connected to the another hub node. So we can see in the demo that how it's working inside. So what is the requirement of the Flex cluster? The Flex cluster requirement is a Flex ASM is required. So for the Flex cluster, Flex ASM required, but vice versa is not necessary. Means Flex ASM does not require Flex cluster. It might be Flex ASM might be on the standard cluster also or Flex cluster also. But Flex cluster required this Flex ASM. I'm not connected to Flex ASM based storage. So hub node is directly connected to the Flex ASM based storage. Means this leaf node is not connected to ASM. Hub node is connected and leaf node is connected via hub to accessing the data. Now the hub node. What is this hub node? Hub node is similar to the node in the Oracle cluster standard cluster configuration. So hub node is nothing. Means a standard cluster configuration where you are in your cluster there is a different system node 1, node 2, that is called the hub node and is directly connected to the shared storage OCR and voting disk. So means you directly ping that heartbeat to sending that heartbeat to the OCR and voting disk. So that is part of the cluster. Run database instances, ASM, Flex instances and resources for the application. Database instances, ASM instances, those are running on the hub node. Maximum number of hub nodes can be 64. But I don't think so for the 19C or 12.2 is might be a change. But 12.1 when it was introduced is 64. We can check also CRCTL get cluster hub size. Then we can know that what is this maximum size of that. And means that parameter set, but we can increase to the 64. Mainly attend to the add manage request of leaf node connected to the them. So hub node is providing the services to the leaf node. Leaf node is not directly connected with the ASM or not able to access this OCR and voting disk. Is connecting means it's not connecting OCR or voting disk, but is any things required to access is access via hub node only. So it means hub node is not required that is necessary to having the leaf node. It's running without leaf node also. What is a leaf node? So leaf node is contain the application specific workload. Like we are putting some application or installing that Oracle client and other things. And lightweight, loosely coupled work as a spoke. So it's a it's nothing. I mean, it's not if you are doing something or in a leaf node or doing anything on that installation or other things, it will be not impacted to the running clusters. It's lightweighted. If one hub node is not available, it's connected to the another hub node. Does not contain the database, ASM instances or VIPs. Databases or ASM instances or VIPs are not required on that, means it's not running on that leaf node. Connected to a hub node, get access to them resources. So whatever things are required to access is done via that hub node. One leaf node is one at a time is connected to the one hub node only. But one hub node, that connected hub node will reboot it or that cluster is shut down. Then it will be connected to the another hub node. So we will see that demo also. No interconnect required among the leaf nodes. However, it exists between the hub node and associated leaf node. So you know that in the hub node, means that cluster, we have that interconnected, means the different nodes are interconnected. But in the case of leaf node, it's not. Leaf node is not interconnected. Leaf node is directly connected with the hub node, associated hub node, and through that hub node is connected, if required, is connected to the leaf, different leaf nodes. And leaf node also using the GNS to discover the, yes, that is very important features. So means that is very important things. So leaf node, how leaf node is connecting to the hub node, that is, that's why GNS is required. Through GNS, means GNS is maintaining that names and other things in behalf of that entire system. So leaf node is directly connected to the GNS to know that the hub node and accordingly that is connected to that hub node. So whenever leaf node wants to access something, is go via GNS. So GNS provide that hub node details to connect with. That is very mandatory thing. Sometimes might be interviewer is also asked to you that how this leaf node is connecting directly to the hub node. So that's why the GNS concept is required. GNS is mandatory to implement that Flex cluster, not for the Flex SM. Flex SM we can install, we can configure, but Flex cluster we require that GNS. Now that few important and the points which is important to regarding this hub and leaf models. So what is this important points? Leaf nodes share the same public and private network as hub nodes. Leaf node also in the same subnets in the public and private network as a hub node. So it's necessary, otherwise both are not connected. When hub node goes down, all the connected leaf nodes get evicted. So when a hub node goes down, all those connected leaf nodes get evicted and again is joined and added back to the cluster again by starting the cluster where services where they find new hub node. Means suppose one leaf node is connected with another hub node, and if that hub node is goes down, then it's evicted from the cluster for time being, and then it's joined again, and it's joined and it's find a new hub node via GNS, and it's connect to that hub node. We will see that demo. We have that, we have prepared all those demos. So we will see that hub node demos. So first we complete this theory part, to understand that during that demo session, we understand that what is the purpose of these commands and other things. So better we can fastly complete this theoretical thing, and then we can see that demos. Heartbeat, heartbeat means between hub node and leaf node. So heartbeat and these things means when this leaf node is evicted for the cluster is defined that 30 seconds default value is 30 seconds. When the 30 second is not get response from the hub node, then it's evicted. So how we can see that these things? So you can see that CTL get CSS leaf miscount. Then you can find these things. And another question is that can we change this value to 30 minute to 1 minute? So yes, we can able to change. We can use the CRSCTL modify command. Less node interaction and condenser on cluster resources. So you can see that we are maintaining that application on leaf node, and leaf node is not directly connected to the OCR and voting disk. So there is a no so contention network contention is also very less, because only that specific hub node will sending those heartbeat and other details through that voting disk and all, and the leaf node is not sending any details. So if you can put that 100 or 1000 leaf node, you can create the 100 or 1000 leaf nodes in your cluster. So that much heartbeat or other things are not going to the OCR or voting disk. So it's a less contention on network also. It's maintained by only those hub nodes registered in OCR and voting disk. So other feature is that role configuration means that is node is a leaf node or hub node is maintaining the locally is maintaining the locally. So during the installation time, so when the node is started, so it's read those local files and all, and configure that role is a leaf or hub node. So if you are upgrading Oracle Flex cluster, so you require to do that upgrade on the hub node first, then you can touch the leaf node. Network heartbeat exists between the hub node and if leaf node, not among the leaf nodes. means a network heart between, as we discussed previously also, that heartbeat is maintained between hub node and leaf node. One leaf node is not directly connected with another leaf node. That heartbeat is not maintained. Services running on the failed leaf node will be failed over the other leaf node connected to the same hub node. Hence, no impact on running services. So in leaf node, if some services is running, and that services means leaf node is a failed or non-rebooted or something, that those services is transferred to the another leaf node. Now we are going to see that Oracle Flex in more detail. So Oracle Flex ASM eliminate requirement of ASM instance on every cluster node. That is first requirement. Every cluster node do not require that ASM instances. Database instances can connect to any instances in the cluster. So database instances can be connect any ASM instances in the cluster, because that database is using that ASM listener. And ASM listener is maintaining the ASM services, and ASM services having the different load balancer, means different ASM information. So one time you are connected to the if your database is means that node, that if ASM instance is not running, so sometime you are connected with the different ASM instances, and later on you are connected with the different ASM instances. It's maintained by the services. ASM listener is reconnected to the available ASM instances. And yes, administrator specific, the cardinality of ASM instances default is a 3. You can also see, we will see in the demo classes that how we can make it some different values, and how the ASM instance will start and stop according to that values. So we have that four possible configuration of ASM instance is a four different possibilities. We are going to one by one. This is the first possibilities, where that local ASM client standard mode. Standard mode, matlab standard mode means like every database node having that own ASM instances. In a standard mode, the instances connect to the ASM client running on the same host. No, this possible configuration for flex ASM, not for that normal ASM. So it's not, it's like means how we can maintain that means local ASM client and other things. So in standard mode, DB instances connect to the ASM client running on the same host or node. They support only the on hub node only. So here the number of instances, so number of ASM instances. So cardinality equals to number of nodes. So how many ASM instances is required here is the same as the number of nodes. So cardinality equals to the number of nodes. ASM client has a direct access to the ASM disk. So every ASM client having the direct access to the ASM disk. ASM metadata moves between the ASM DB instances. So directly it will be connect and the things are maintained. Does not use flex ASM features. Does not use the flex ASM features, because it's, every node is maintaining own ASM instances. So it's a standard configuration mode. It's not using that flex ASM things. Second one is a pure flex ASM mode. So pure flex ASM mode means DB client running on the hub node access ASM remotely via metadata and allow to the direct input output disk. So as we discussed that is using that ASM services, through that ASM services is accessing that the, so it does not matter that ASM is running on that node or not, it will be using that services and connecting or fetching the data from through means ASM fetching those data through this ASM services. DB instances can be on different nodes than ASM instance. Yes, correct. DB instances can be running on the different node, different system, and ASM instances is running on the different node. ASM metadata moves between ASM and DB instances. Cardinality is not equal to number of nodes. So it means it's not like that in Flex ASM we don't have that if three node hierarchy is mandatory to maintain only two ASM instances. No. If three we have, then we can maintain three also. Means cardinality equals to number of node also. But for pure Flex ASM, the cardinality is do not require to maintain the same way. The number of node, you have the number of Flex ASM. You have to maintain two also. Three node we have, then we can maintain two cardinality for the ASM instances two. So DB instances can access locally or remotely ASM network. So as is using that ASM services, so it's either it's connected to the locally if the ASM instance running on the same node, or if not, is accessing through the remotely. ACFS through ASM proxy instances. So ACFS, like AC, as we discussed previously also, that ACFS is nothing, is the on ASM we are creating one file system which is mounted to the server. So whatever things we are putting in that file system is going to the on ASM. So this way also, so there is a one proxy, ASM proxy concept is there. So where this ACFS is running, that there is a one proxy instances is running. So proxy instances will means that proxy instances is connecting to the means this ASM disk storage and all, and is maintaining in that. We will see that these things are already in next slide. We have those differences and things also. So last mode is a mixed mode. Mixed mode, like we have that 12G databases and 11G databases also. Then in a cluster, how we can maintain? So in that cases, we require that cardinality equals to the number of node, because old DBs will not, if old DBs means pre-12C DB will require that ASM instances running on the same node. So here we have that number of ASM instances equals to the cardinality, and the instance count is the same. So suppose in this server, suppose if ASM instance is got crushed or somebody stopped this ASM instance, what happened to this database? So in this case, the DB, this DB and this DB will stop working, and only this 12C related DB will connect the through remote ASM, and it will be does not impact it. So this DB will 12C DB is available, and other two DBs will got crashed. It's shut down because ASM is not there. So then few silent points here, that clusterware ensure the cardinality is maintained in at all time. No Flex ASM specific instance parameter are required. So Flex ASM, we do not have any specific parameter to maintain. ASM server instances use automatic memory management. Administration can be done using this. We can manage these things by SRVCTL command, ASMCA, CRCTL command, or SQL plus command. Flex cluster required Flex ASM. However, Flex ASM does not require the Flex cluster. It's correct. Flex cluster required Flex ASM, but Flex ASM either in the Flex cluster or in the standard cluster. And now we have that few definition, and then we have that other things. So this is the ASM network we have already discussed. So ASM network is like a new type of network introduced in a Flex ASM 12C, used for the communication between ASM and client. And can be configured as a separate network on the private interconnect network. We have that option during the installation. Either we can use this private interconnect, or we can maintain another ASM network for this ASM things. Second, ASM filter driver. ASM filter driver is introduced in 12th release 1. And you know that previously we are using that, what do you say, that raw devices. And later on we have that Oracle ASM. Means one software is there where we are installing that OSM support, lib and other key mode to maintain this Oracle ASM and to maintaining that ASM disk. So ASM filter driver is a new thing. What is means is if you compare with the ASM lib, the ASM filter driver is more good utilities in terms of that functionality the same as ASM lib, Oracle ASM ASM library. But the difference is that when you are configured this ASM lib, Oracle ASM using, that time anybody can if try to write something that through DD command on Unix, we have the DD command to writing on the raw devices. So if you use the DD command and write something in that ASM using the disk, then those file system will corrupted, means that ASM will not available. But ASM filter driver is maintaining, is directly coupled with the kernel and is maintaining those things and security things that other than Oracle, nobody will able to write those things on the either using the DD command or any other command to that ASM disk. So this is very, and also is very easy to configure also, or very easy to maintain also. So this is the ASM filter driver. And another is the ASM listener. So ASM listener is introduced with a flex ASM. A set of ASM listener configured to the every ASM network in a flex ASM, up to three ASM listener address are registered as remote listener in each client DB instances. Client connection get load balance across all ASM instances. So ASM listener is the same like a scan listener type thing. Is also maintaining that number of up to three ASM listener. So it's maintaining in that way. So if and another is the that proxy, ADBM proxy. So special Oracle instances that run on the same node as ADBM and ACFS. For ACFS is actually CUD. Enable ADBM to connect to the flex ASM and can be shut down when ACFS is not running. So it's the purpose of the ACFS that file system is mounted to the node. So this proxy is using to maintain these things on the ASM. So whatever things are you putting in that file system is actually going to that ASM. So it's going via ADM proxy. So when you have that ACFS is not configured or you are not using, so does not require this ADM proxy. Now, how you can convert this standard ASM to the flex ASM? So let me unmute you all that if you have any questions or something, or it's not clear, then I can discuss right now. So I just unmuted all. So if you have any questions, then let me know. No further question? Okay, let me move. So means how we can convert this standard ASM to the flex ASM. So we have that two options to either we can use this ASM with GUI. Here is a typo mistake. It's not GUI. The second one is through command line. So ASM using GUI, then we have that ASM CA. We can use this ASM CA. You can see that we have that in picture. It's not clear, but it's converted to the flex ASM. We have one option here. So when you click that one, then it will be converted to the flex ASM. But after that also, you require to run this this file for both in a silent also, or this this also GUI also. You say last one is required to run, then it's converted to the FlexAs. So in ASM CMA, either we can use in a silent mode. Silent mode we can use this silent, convert to the Flex ASM, ASM network name. We can use this private one. Then we can prove the subnet of private one and the listener port. And then after that, we will run this SS script that will be convert these things to the Flex ASM. And it's run through the grid or grid home owner user. Either it's a grid or it's Oracle. Now, how you can install this Oracle grid, means a Flex cluster. So Flex cluster, you need to, I will show you that not complete installation demo, but I will show you that configuration in demo section. So in here, I'm just moving with the slide that from one node, if you run this grid setup .sh, then you have that this one, the you need to install the new cluster, then you can select the new cluster. Then you have to select that standalone cluster or cluster. And then here you have that cluster name you can put, scan name you can put. And then you need to check that for the Flex cluster, you need to check that configure GNS. And GNS, and then you can provide that in GNS VIP address, you can provide that IP addresses of the GNS. So in our cases, the IP addresses is 192.168.0.250. So you need to provide that 250, and GNS subdomain name is the name of that GNS. So gns.anurag.server.com in our cases. So we can put here, and then we can proceed further. And rest of the steps is the same as a standard cluster. So conversion from the standard cluster to the Flex cluster. If you want to convert that standard cluster to the Flex cluster, how you can do that? So for that, grid naming service GNS is mandatory. Required in static IP GNS VIPs, as we discussed, that GNS is mandatory to convert in the Flex cluster. So GNS VIP must be static IP addresses, and is already means if you fire this NS lookup, it will be some host name is coming. So means that is that is already registered with the DNS. So GNS VIP is required. Flex ASM mode should be enabled. So Flex ASM mode should be enabled mode. For the Flex cluster, Flex ASM is required. So Flex ASM is mandatory for the Flex cluster. Required cluster downtime. Yes, we have the required that downtime. On live cluster, you can't touch these things, and you can't do these things. So you require that cluster downtime. Zone delegation is not required. You have that optional thing that you want to miss here. If you see that here, that configure GNS, now there is a second option, configure nodes virtual IP as assigned by the dynamic network. So if you check this option, means that GNS is maintaining that node VIPs also. So in that case, you do not require to put that VIPs for the node also, is maintained by the GNS itself. Only you require that 4 static IP address, 3 for the scan IPs, which is registered in the DNS, and 1 for the GNS VIPs. And rest of the IP you do not require or bother, because you have that DNS and DHCP server configured in your environment, and GNS is just connect with your DHCP and GNS and get those IPs and register the name according to the node name. So in this case, the zone delegation is not mandatory. If you have that option to select it, if you are not selecting this zone delegation, then that time you require to maintain that static things for the three scan IPs, one GNS VIPs, and the node public and VIPs, and this one private also you can maintain in the DNS. And once you can convert it to the flux cluster, you can't revert. Standard cluster can be converted in the flux cluster, but flux cluster not able to convert again in the standard cluster. That is the limitation. So how you can do that? Determine the current cluster mode. So you need to fire this command cicl get cluster mode status, and then you will see that the what is your cluster mode, is a flex or is a standard. Is a standard, then you can convert it. If it is already flex, then it doesn't require. Then you can check that because VIP GNS is required, so you need to check that server config GNS. If it's not there, then you need to add it in this way. Then again, you need to start the GNS first and enable ASM to run as a flex mode using ASMCA or ASMCA in silent mode. Means that ASM flex ASM is also required. So we need to convert that standard ASM to the flex ASM before proceeding with the flex cluster. Then change the mode to the flex as a root on any node. So now you are changing this cluster mode to the flex from any node. So now when you're changing this mode and everything, things are already there, then without giving any error, it's converted to the flex. So, and when you stop and CRS and start it one node at a time, means you required one by one, then it will be converted as a flex cluster. So that is the standard way to. So we have covered two things. One is how to move that standard flex standard ASM to flex ASM, and how we can standard cluster to the flex cluster. Next thing, the node role change leaf to hub node. So let me quickly go through, or we can also see in the demo section. So better we can see in the demo section, because we have also the limitation of time also. So we need to finish at the 9:30 anyhow. So let me stop here and let me go to that. I will show you that where we are. Sorry. So in this point we have covered. So now we have two pending from here. Node role changes from leaf node to hub node. So in our configuration, we have installed four. We have that four system. One is we are maintaining as a DNS. This is our, if you see that, this node is a DNS server. So we have is maintaining that DNS and DHCP server. So this server is a DNS and DHCP server. Is a Linux server 7.7, Oracle Linux. And we have created one separate one. And here, if you see that, it is the host file entries. So we have do not have any only DNS entries there, and nothing entry is there. But if you fire this NS lookup rack scan, it will be giving that this scan IP details. If you fire that any node name rack 3 rack 1, it will be returned that this one IP addresses. So same like if you fire that rack 3 rack 2 prib, so it will be give that private IP of the rack. So it's configured as a DNS server, as a DHCP server, and on top of that is maintaining that the GNS also. So this is the configuration of first server. And we have that three other servers. This is our first node. So this is our first node. So if you go to, so currently I'm in the bin directory only. So if you see that CRS CTL status resources minus tabular form, then you will see that this is the two node rack. It's a two node rack. But let me check that this one. what is the node configuration of this whole cluster? So CRS CTL get node role. So let me unmute you all. So whenever you feel that the font size is smaller or is then you can talk also. Unmute yourself and talk it. So can I increase the font size? Or is it visible? Now it's okay? Let me clear the screen first. So now if you want to check that in this cluster, the how many nodes are there and which nodes are maintaining which role, is a hub node or is a this one, leaf node. Then how we can check? We can CRSCTL get node role config. If you fire this command, it will be show on the current node only. If you fire with the all command, then it will be so here in our case, we have created the two node, three node system we have. So two node we are maintaining as a hub node and one node we are maintaining as a leaf node. That's why if you fire this command resources, you are not seeing any resources running on the third node, rack three. You are not able to see that rack three. Got it? Because rack three, we do not have that resources running, because that is the leaf node. That's why you are not able to see that any resources are running on that rack three. It's not running. So if we go to that the node three, and so in node three is a leaf node. So let me connect to the another instances. Go to the node three. So node three, if we go to this, check that status. So here also you are able to check the status of the cluster, but is directly not connected with the cluster. But is these information are coming through any hub node. So how you can know that which hub node is coming and which node is connected, then you have to go to this location in your app Oracle Diag folder, and there is a trace file, CRS trace file. There is a OCSS DRM trace file is there. So sending a ping message to, every time is sending the heartbeat to hub node. So it's sending that node to which one? So if you see that, it's connected with the node two. It's connected with the rack two. Means this leaf node, node three is connected with the node two. So if any cases node two is got down, then it will be switched to the another existing node. So we later on we can see. So first we will see. So you understand that what is the configuration we have? we have that means three node rack system, and one node for and one host we are maintaining for the DNS and for GNS and DHCP, and three other node we have. Every node we have that 16 GB RAM. So if you see that here we are maintaining the 16 GB RAM, and leaf node we have given that 8 GB RAM. So here we are maintaining the 16 GB RAM, and also if you see that the we are maintaining the two core processor here. So here in a leaf node we have maintaining one core processor, and here in the DHCP DNS server we are maintaining one core processor and 2 GB RAM only, because it's a no additional memory requirement here. So now we can start with this presentation. We are going to switch that leaf node to hub node. We are going to create that leaf node to a complete rack hub node to maintain the databases also. How we can do that? We will see that. So one by one we can go. So on node 3, so here we can take this one. So node 3, first we need to okay. So before that, let me check that how we can know that this is the flex cluster or not. From leaf node you can understand that hub and leaf, but we have that different command also. So yes, so for that, how we can this is running, this cluster is running in the flex mode, and obvious that is a cluster is running in the flex mode. So this ASM is also running in the flex mode, but how we can check that is we can ASM CMD show cluster mode. So here we can check that flex mode is enabled. So now we are going converting that leaf node, that leaf node to that leaf node to converting that leaf node to hub node. That is our agenda. This one we are making rack 3, we are making to the hub node. So for that, and also we can see that there is a one database is also rack database is running, that is ORCL1, and on node 2 is ORCL2. And either ASM is also running, but if you see in the node 3, so you will not see that any databases or ASM is running here. So and also if you check that here, that VIP is also not only for the rack 1 and rack 2. Here you will not see that the VIP of the rack 3, because this is a leaf node. So now we are going to convert it into the hub node. So for that, so let me fire this first. We need to go with this node and with is a leaf node, correct one. So first we require to add that VIP, because we are going to maintain. So here if you see that the requirement, first we need to check that role configuration, and then after that we require to check that we require the VIP, a local node. So for rack 3 we do not have any VIPs, so first we will add that VIP, and then we will start that role changing from leaf to hub. So we are going to add that VIP. So on the first node or any node, you need to fire because you are adding this VIPs, so you need to fire with this command with the root user. And this command is servicetl add VIPs. Which node is a rack 3 address. So we have already defined that address in a DNS, just that VIP address. So we have picked that address, and then we have putting into in which network, in network one, we have that only one network. So if you see here, so we have that network one. If you have that multiple network, you want to add in another one, then this value is 1 or 2 or 3 based on that. So we have that only one network. So we are putting the network number is a 1. So we are adding this VIP to the this one. What is saying that fail to add resources Aura rack 3 VIP to create the VIP on node 3 because network name is not extended to work on the leaf node. Okay, so this will be not work until and unless we have not convert these things to the first we require to role changing. Once you change the role, then you are able to convert it. So let me first change that role, then we can try. So for role changing, we have simple command crsctl. On which node you are going to change it, fire that command with the root user, crsctl set node role hub. That is command. So we are changing this. So now it's a changes to the hub node. But if you change that hub node also, if you fire this command to check it, it will be giving that or is role is changes, but still the role is leaf there. And so you require to restart that high ability service to come in the current role. Means after every role changes, you require to restart that CRS, CRS services. So before restarting this, we can stop and we can start the CRS. So for CRS stop, we are crsctl stop CRS. So now we are stopping this CRS on the node 3. So once you stopping this things to node 3, then we will check that command, what the command is saying. So now it says stop. So if you check here also, CTL check CRS, then it's saying that, okay, it's not running. So when we will go here and we will try to check that status of that, then you will see that only node over rack 1 and rack 2 is coming. Even rack 3 is not coming, and it's not that status is also, means some error is also not showing here. Okay. So don't worry, it's because that is CRS is not started. So we will start that CRS here. And then we will create that VIPs. Now CRS is started. Maybe some other process is not completely started, might be. It will wait. Need to wait a few minutes, then we can see that. Now we can see that this role is converted to the hub node, but still things are not completed because we have not the VIPs is not there. So if you see that, it will be take few minutes. Okay. Here we can see that. So here you can see that the VIP 3 is not comes in the picture. BIP is not only two BIPs is there. So we require to create the third one. So now we are firing this command. So it will be create that VIP3 in the cluster. And then we have required to start this VIPs. Well, let me check that status. Is showing that offline. So now we can start that. How we can start? We are using everything resources we are managing through this one. SRV schedule command and VIP. Which VIP? Either you can put that VIP name or you can put that node name. So now it's started. If you see that VIP3 is online. And here also, if you check that, try to check that status, it will be showing online. So now in this demo, what we did, we have converted that leaf node to the hub node. So if you have any questions, then let me know. You can unmute yourself and you can talk. No further question? So now when it's converted to the leaf means hub node, then if you see that, then ASM instance is also started here. Okay, so now I want to change this cardinality to means if you check that status of ASM, then it's running to the all those nodes. If you check that status of ASM, so is ASM is running on all three, all nodes, because we have that cardinality value is 3. So let me change this value to 2, because we can change up to 2 only. This 1 we can't put 1. So now I am changing this value to count 1. So let's see what happened. Now we can check that. So how many and which node is running right now? Is running on the rack 3 and rack 1. It's a stop on the rack 2. If we go to rack 2 and if we try to see that is ASM instance is there, so it's not there. It's a stop. This one is a stop. Okay, so this is this things is also clear that how we can maintain the ASM instances in the means flex ASM. So now again we are I'm changing this value to count 3, because we are going to hub, making hub node to the leaf node again. So now if you see that, so every node having that own ASM. So if you go to here and again check, then ASM running, ASM is again started. Okay. So now this ASM demo is also clear to you all. Now I'm going to convert this hub node to leaf node. Or we can also through slide also we can cover it. If you want, then I can go through that one. Otherwise, I can cover through slide also. So here, let me. So here, if you see that, we have to understand that how we can convert leaf to the hub node. So for the hub to the leaf node, so hub to leaf node, first we require to check that role of that local node, that is CICTL get node role config. Then after that, we require to put it as a leaf node and then stop that CRS. And no, one steps we have missed, I think, in a leaf to hub node also. Because we have converted, but we have not put the information into the central repository. We required to put this information into the central repository also. So for that, we required to fire this command to get registered that leaf node to hub node in the central inventory also. So for that, we required to fire that command. So we have missed that one. So what we do, we'll go here and we can stop CRS first. Stop CRS. And on the this one. On the node 1 and node 2 with root user. Because run installation is run by root user only. One by one, we require to fire this command. This is updating that cluster node, means the hub node to rack 1, rack 2, rack 3. So we need to fire this command. One by one. In between, I log in here also in node 2. Fire same command, but one by one, not. So it's successfully updated. Same way we can fire here also. Once it's updated, we can start that cluster again. So let me start with presentation because we have very less time. So we. So here, leaf to hub node, we fire this command and then we can start this CRS on the rack 3 in our case. Same way to hub to leaf node, you need to check that role on that node which you want to convert. Then you need to transfer that hub to leaf node, that fire this CRSCTL set node role leaf command. Then stop CRS. Then you can update this, fire this run installer and local node. And update this node information to leaf node in that server. And then on the other nodes, you need to fire this one. And only this previously we have fired this rack 1, rack 2, rack 3 in a hub node. So we can just only put rack 1 and rack 2 in this hub load list. And we can fire this command on both nodes. And then we can start the CRS. This is the demo for this. Hub to leaf node conversion. So what is changes now? I'm covering that what is changes in 18c and 19c in regarding this flex cluster. I'm not talking about the other features. of either rack or an 18c database. I am just covering this flex cluster part. So flex cluster, we have that hub and leaf node. Starting with Oracle 18c, leaf nodes are deprecated as part of the Oracle flex cluster architecture. So Oracle was decided to do not investigate or make this leaf node any further. So it's remove this concept of the leaf node, and in a future edition it will be completely deprecated. With continuous improvement in the Oracle cluster way stack towards providing shorter recognition time, failure leaf nodes are no longer necessary for implementing the cluster that meet the customer needs, either on the on-premises or in the cloud. So this is not required. So node is in coming edition, it will be fully deprecated. So now in 18c, there is one more concept called is a reader node. So what is a reader node? Oracle Rack reader node is facility for Oracle Flex Cluster. By allocating a set of read-write instances running in Oracle Transfer Processing, set of read-only means you can create one read-only database instances on the leaf node. So there you can put that all those load to fetch that report and other details from the leaf node. So you have that that node is called reader node. That is nothing is a leaf node, and where you can put this read-only databases. So if you see that things and other concept of this things, then you can just confuse that what is the leaf node. Again, then we are creating the databases instances. So that's why this different wordings. That's why Oracle is going to means remove this leaf things concept and put it this in a different way. It's called reader node instead of leaf node. So the reader node is nothing. You can create that rack instances, that one instance is on the hub node and one instance is on the leaf node, and that leaf node is only reader only mode from means like active data guard, you can say. So there you can only able to face that report and other things. So in 19c, that the flex things are completely deprecated. It's not supported 19c onwards. So these things are completely removed from the 19c. This is the additional features. So now we have that if you want this question and answer, then let me know. Otherwise we can, if you have any questions, then let me know. You all are unmuted or muted? I don't know. Any further question? So we have the 12 minutes, then we can utilize that 12 minutes also. So let me convert this leaf node to again to the means hub node to leaf node again. Let me log in with root user. First we check that okay, because we have not started this one, we need to start this CRS. So in we have also starting that one rack batches from 4th Jan. So in that rack batches we have already announced that we have let me show you. So we have this rack batches. We are covering that in a complete details of that clusterware rack ASM architecture. We are covering that startup sequence in details. We are covering that the background process in details. We are completely administration of clusterware rack ASM, flex ASM, flex cluster architecture, lab sessions. We have come covering this one node rack policy manage, admin manage, server pools, one node rack concepts, convert from one node to rack, rack to one node, upgrade of 12C grid to 19C grid, patchings, and cloning of grid home, Oracle home, and troubleshooting using that TAF and ORA check in our lab sessions. So actually in our cases, we are providing that complete documents also. And we are providing that complete step-by-step documents. Let me show you. So here we are for the one batch where we are conducting this, means is about to complete. There we have that document that how, means in these documents, if you see that, you will able to, anybody will able to easily install this rack system in their system, then laptop also. So the minimum requirement is for one machine is 4 GB, means 4 GB one per rack node. So you if you have the 16 GB RAM in your laptop, then you can easily install this rack setup in your lab. In laptop. So these are the means this is the documents, standard documents where you are able to follow these things. So same way we are providing the different documents also for different, like this one is for the OS installation, this one for this node preparation and all, then how you can install this Oracle ASM packages library, how we can set those things. So in these documents, you can easily see that how we can set that network, and that each steps you can see that in pictures also, and in this way also, then how you can go to there and how you can which one is required to on or which one is required to off. Those small things is also covered in this complete documents. So we are providing the same way that all those documents. So this is, and we are charging that this one is a 4999, but for new year offer we are only charging for 9999 for this one. So this is the agenda. We are starting from the 4th of January. So now let me convert this one, and then we can, if anybody wants to go, then so now let me convert it to the, we can follow this one process here from. Here we need to convert from hub node to leaf node. So let me take few questions, is put it in the chat boxes. So let me take few questions. Raghu is asking that will you provide demo video after this class is over? I don't think so is possible. I'm not able to understand as well as will that GNS work same as DNS? Yes, GNS is work same as a DNS, but DNS is the generic purpose of that host like but DNS GNS is only purpose for the Oracle clusterware. So you have that set of IPs, like if you put it that 30-40 IPs in that range, that subdomains, then the GNS will assign those IPs and accordingly they will take those IPs and put that relevant names. Suppose for if you taking this as a domain, then for the each node VIPs is put it that rack one hyphen VIP and some IPs from getting from that range only. DHCP is allocate that IPs on that range only. So it's not static IP, it's dynamic IPs. One question is leaf node. Umar is asking one question is leaf node has also the grid and RDBMS binaries. Is a good question. Leaf node only we have that grid binaries, not the RDBMS binaries. We don't have that RDBMS binaries. We have that grid binaries. During that installation, when you select that leaf node, it will be asked that means it will be installed, push this grid binaries to that leaf node. PDF share this session. Okay, we will try. Murali, one question with that GNS works same as the DNS. Yes, GNS is works same as the DNS. I already talk previously about this. So it's same works same like the DNS, but GNS is for the Oracle cluster here. Prerequisite for this course, prerequisite for this rack courses is only that you know that basic of databases. ASM means you know that the instances, you know that the memory structures, that's it. Rest of the things we'll cover from the basics and the step by step documents is shared with you all. Murali is asking complete leaf and hub are in the one box like Exa machine. I don't understand why you want to put in the all those leaf and hub on the one same boxes. You want to say that you want to create that DEM 0, DEM 1 means like virtual machines like same. If you are talking about the virtual machine, if you have the different machines, you can put any things. So yes, it will be work that like also. Yes, this question is also covered that the leaf node only have the this one grid binaries, not the RDBMS binaries. So we are almost touched the timeline, so we can't go further on that. So if you have any questions, then you can talk. Otherwise, we can happy to close this call. Thank you very much for your joining this call and attended the whole session. Thank you very much. Bye all. Good night.
Yeah, thank you, Anurag sir. Thank you very much.